Now we're going to run the Novabench benchmark tests. I would expect these two computers to have a similar speed, bearing in mind the laptop is a lot older than the tablet. The test takes about a minute and tests a variety of the computer's functionalities. This is interesting, the graphics test. ...57 frames a second on the laptop and 106 frames per second on the tablet. So on the laptop we have a score of 377 and on the tablet we have a score of 352. Very similar actually. I'll just zoom in on the results for you so you can compare them. So the laptop with twice the RAM and a 64-bit operating system has a very similar performance to the tablet actually. In some areas the little tablet is a lot faster. The RAM speed is faster at 4008 megabytes per second, whereas it was only 3403 on the laptop. The CPU tests are very, very similar, slightly lower on the little tablet. The graphics tests are twice as fast on the tablet than they are on the laptop. And the disk transfer speed is faster on the laptop than on the tablet. So all in all, I think the little tablet's done very well. Now we're going to take a look at the tablets from the point of view of expandability. And this device here is a USB on-the-go cable, which should theoretically connect straight onto this tablet and allow us to put full-size USB devices in. So this is a wireless keyboard and mouse controller. And I'm going to plug it in so that we can attempt to have access to a wireless keyboard. So now you can see I've plugged in the USB on the go cable and I've plugged in the keyboard and mouse controller and we have full control over the mouse without any software installation. It's automatically detected the USB on the go cable and the device. So I'm just going to open Adobe Photoshop CC. This is the full version of Photoshop and I've downloaded a trial version from Adobe's website. And you will see that we can use full Windows software on this tablet. This is not some cut down version like the ones for the iPad and Android. This is full Photoshop. And as such, it allows us to import. Here's a picture I've imported earlier. So, tiny little tablet is capable of running Photoshop quite happily and we can make adjustments to the image and it actually reacts very quickly. There's no lag or delay in the operation of this. This is an 8 megapixel image, so it's not the biggest in the world. Shot actually on the onboard camera. Very good quality camera on these Toshiba tablets. Now the battery life on this tablet is quoted at around 8 hours. And I've installed a little app here which is called Battery Bar, which is a very handy Windows app. That allows you to see exactly how much battery life you have left. I've tended to find that this little tablet gives you about nine and a half hours of battery life on a charge, even with continuous use. This is web browsing, a bit of video playing, some photography, etc. And actually, this is quite a good little tablet if you want to be using it all day. It does seem to actually have that capability to give you a charge that lasts all day in fairly continuous use. So quite a useful device really if you're on a long train journey or planes quite a lot. This will let you use your PC programs for a good 7, 8, 9 hours of continuous use. And I haven't done anything like tweaking the battery life up by displaying dimming or anything like that. It's on the completely standard settings it came with. I'm going to install a full-size USB 3 hard disk, 2 terabytes to the tablet. Obviously this tablet does not have USB 3, it has USB 2, but it should work, although when the disk spins up it will probably use an enormous amount more power.
So here we go. You can see that the disc has self-installed. Let's just give you a bit bigger view of that. And open folder to view files. So here we have a very large hard disk attached to the computer. So it's as simple as that. Plugging in the hard disk allows you immediately to have access to a large number of files. So you can, on 32 gig, you can probably install quite a few useful programs on this, but you have to remember that you're not going to be able to store very much data on it. It's now only got 7 gigabytes free, but that would allow you to install 5 or 6 premium programs and still have 3 or 4 gigs spare. So you could put Cubase on here and still run it with a little bit of space to spare. Although with 2 gig of RAM, it's doubtful what you'd be able to do with those programs. You could theoretically run some fairly heavy software on this PC and it would work quite well. Now this USB on the go cable also does give you access to plugging in a hub to this computer. So you could in theory connect a large number of USB devices just by connecting it to a hub. And away you go, you've got all the breakout functionality of connecting USB audio interfaces, other recording devices, and using this tablet for far more than just a media browsing device, which is pretty much what an Android or an iPad tablet is. I've connected a USB pen drive, a 30 gig USB pen drive here, and I've also connected a 2 terabyte hard disk. And these work absolutely perfectly. If you, for example, if you open these are all loops for Cubase. So you can play any of them and they will work perfectly. Royalty free loops, by the way, Google, if you hear that. So as you can see, the USB connectivity of this is very, very good, and it allows you to install a variety of hard disks, SD cards, and other devices through a USB hub. I'll just show you the USB hub connected to this. Excuse the table. We have the drive there, and the USB hub here, powered USB hub. And it's allowed the expansion of this tablet to be a very useful device.